Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. You ever been working with an aggregation and you're using iterators in some of your measures and it just doesn't hit the ag? How do you fix it? Well, in this video, I'm gonna show you. Stay tuned. This for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, it's working with someone, we're doing some ag work, and they're like, well, Patrick, it's not hitting or missing the ag, and I'm not quite sure what's happening. I had an idea of what it was, but I wanted to validate it. All right, so you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. They created a table that looked like this, and they used a measure that used an iterator function. So a sum X or a min X. So what happened was we launched DAX Studio, turned on all queries, wait for our trace to start, and we're connected to the model locally. And I went to view, performance analyzer, and start recording, and I refreshed that visual. And clearly, it's definitely hitting direct query. Right? It's missing my aggregation. I have my aggregations all configured. If you don't know how to configure ags, I have a whole list of videos out on our YouTube channel. You can go watch all the videos. It talks about configuring ags. So after we refresh the visual, if you go to DAX Studio, you'll see there's in my all queries view, you'll see that the query came through, but there's not a solid circle or a single circle. The solid one indicates that it hit the ag, circle means it missed the ag, but this one didn't do anything. So my first thought was you didn't configure ags properly. They did. And then my next thought was, oh, I saw something. Let me show you. So if you take a look at this measure that they wrote, it's an iterator function. Iterator functions aren't supported by ags. And so what do? You try to take the logic here and do what? Push it upstream. If you have access to the source, go to the source. If not, do it in Power Query, do it in a data flow. In my case, I have access to the source. So what I did, I created a view that's pointing to internet sales and I did the calculation here. So let me show you what that did for me. So I'm gonna go over here and transform and I'm gonna update two things. So I'm gonna change this from internet sales to my new view. Let's click refresh, there we go. And I actually updated my ag. I created a new ag that's pointing to that new table. All right, let's click refresh, close and apply, give it a little bit to do its thing. Now this is still gonna hit direct query, but that's not what I'm concerned about. What I'm gonna do is go to my ag now, manage aggregations, and hey, this doesn't work. That's all right, go down here to this one, click apply. Now watch this. I'm gonna go over to total sales amount. Instead of using just the sales amount column, I'm gonna use that new one where I did the calculation. And now what I'm gonna do is go to product, grab the color, boom, and then watch my new measure. It's still using the calculation. I just pushed it up to the source, drop it there. Wow, numbers exactly the same. They'll do some formatting. Let's clear this out, start recording, click refresh. Ooh, look, see how fast that one came back? Let's go ahead and copy that query. Let's head back to DAX Studio. Let's turn on server timings. Let's go ahead and run this and see if we get some aggregation. So it found a match, it's definitely hitting the ag. So if you're setting up aggregations and you don't see it hitting or missing, maybe you're doing something that's not ag aware. In our case, we were using an iterator function, which ags don't support them, all right? So do you have any questions? Do you have any comments? Have you run into this before? I'd love to know. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.